Avoiding certain foods can be hard, especially when they're specifically designed to taste good. You generally want to avoid certain foods if you want to turn your life around by taking care of your health. A good place to start is with your diet. So pay attention to what you eat and how much you eat. If you still aren't sure where to start, here is a list of foods you should avoid. Number 11. White bread. White, packaged bread might be unhealthy due to the highly processed flours and chemicals. Obesity, heart disease, and diabetes can all be exacerbated by eating too much white bread. Even whole grain bread might have 20 ingredients or more, including preservatives, extra salt, and sweeteners. The weight of the ingredients in the product is usually used to order the ingredients list. Ingredients near the top of the list will be present in overly large amounts. Most commercial breads are unhealthy if consumed in excessive quantities because they're manufactured from refined wheat, which is lacking in fiber and important nutrients and can cause blood sugar spikes. Ezekiel bread is a great option for folks who can handle wheat. White bread is also less healthy than whole grain bread. If you're gluten intolerant or carbohydrate intolerant, there are many types of bread, and some are healthier than others. Try making bread at home. This way, you will know exactly what you're eating. Some people may choose to invest in a bread-making machine. Number 10. Bakery products. Muffins, cookies, cakes, and donuts are all delicious and tempting sweets people find hard to resist. But all of these baked goodies are pure sugar bombs. One typical donut has between 250 to 500 calories and can have over 60 grams of sugar. Most pastries, cookies, and cakes are unhealthy if eaten in excess. Packaged versions are generally made with refined sugar, refined wheat flour, and added fats. These are a great example of foods that people know are bad for their health, but they eat them just because they're tasty, and in the end, their health suffers. These treats might be tasty, but they have almost no essential nutrients, copious calories, and many preservatives in vending machines. These kinds of goods can cause a lot of digestive problems. Obesity and excessive amounts of sugar can lead to many cardiovascular diseases, as well as teeth problems. To satisfy your cravings, you can eat dark chocolate or protein bars. In moderation, of course. Number 9. Regular soda and diet soda. Everyone knows that soda is very bad for your health. In case you missed the backstory, the average can contains about 10 teaspoons of sugar. When you consume that much, your body responds by creating excess insulin, which typically helps the body absorb sugar from the bloodstream and use it for energy. Over time, though, this over-the-top response can increase your risk of developing diabetes and some forms of cancer. If soda's sugar content still doesn't scare you, its other ingredients might. The amount of caramel coloring you'd consume in one can of soda per day was recently linked to a 58% greater risk of cancer, according to a new study. Not all artificial sweeteners are equally offensive. Over time, the extra sweet sweeteners can dull your senses to naturally sweet foods like fruits, Rifkin says. So yes, your Diet Coke could, theoretically, make a perfectly sweet apple taste worse. Some other problems with drinking diet soda. It's been linked to depression, tooth decay, heightened risk of strokes and heart attacks, pancreatic cancer, and premature birth. So there's that. Number 8. Fruit canned in syrup. The reason this type of fruit is so yummy? Sugar, sugar, and more sugar. When a fruit is canned in light syrup or heavy syrup, that means that sugar has been added to the fruit. Fruit is plenty sweet on its own, so you don't need any added sugar with it. If you like the convenience of canned fruit, here's some good news. There are canned fruits out there that aren't housed in that syrupy mixture. Just make sure to read the ingredient label to make sure a product is canned either in 100% juice or water. Number 7. Instant noodles. A good rule of thumb? When something has the word instant in its name, it's likely something you're going to want to avoid. Whenever I see the word instant, they're doing something to the food to make it that way. They've probably stripped it down and taken away a bit of the fiber and stuff that we actually want. Plus, the amount of sodium in instant noodles is extremely high, and they contain what's called monosodium glutamate, MSG, which has its own set of problems. It's a flavor enhancer that's used in a lot of cooking, or a lot of restaurants we use it. And it is an addictive substance, so we keep coming back as a repeat customer. But with it, it can increase hunger, and that causes us to eat more. Number 6. energy drinks. It's easy to see why a young athlete might think energy drinks are the answer to get them through those long days of school and practice. Popular drink brands sponsor exciting and big-time sports events. Professional athletes endorse them, and the advertisements promise better focus, energy, and performance. But the reality is, these beverages can cause serious harm to young athletes' bodies and minds. You can have higher amounts of sugar in them, or they'll use artificial flavors, which can cause a lot of inflammation of the body. And when it comes to energy drinks, most companies won't disclose what those artificial flavorings actually are. The high amounts of caffeine in the drinks can cause increased blood pressure and heart rate, while other ingredients in the drink may be responsible for abnormal heart rhythms and unexpected heart attacks. Number 5. Tilefish. While seafood is tasty, not all fish are made equal, and there are a few you should avoid if you see them in the shop. One of them is tilefish, which, according to the U.S. Food and Drug Administration, should be avoided since it contains high levels of mercury. Fish is a good staple to add to your diet, but it's best to aim for eating low-mercury, fatty seafood like salmon and sardines, which also have beneficial omega-3s, EPA and DHA, says Gorin. But one fish you might want to avoid ordering when you're out at a seafood restaurant? Tilefish, which is high in mercury, something that can actually cause poisoning if eaten in too high of a concentration. Number 4. Pizza. Pizza is one of the world's most popular junk foods. Most commercial pizzas are made with unhealthy ingredients, including highly refined dough and heavily processed meat. Pizza also tends to be extremely high in calories. Some restaurants offer healthier ingredients. Homemade pizzas can also be very healthy, as long as you choose wholesome ingredients. Did you know a single slice of cheese pizza scores high in the glycemic index? Since it's loaded with straightforward carbs and doesn't offer a lot of satisfying fiber or protein, consuming food that is high on the glycemic list can make you feel hungry afterwards, which might prompt eating more food, and so on. And soon, weight gain. Number 3. Junk food. Junk food is unhealthy food that is high in calories from sugar or fat with little dietary fiber, protein, vitamins, minerals, and other important forms of nutritional value. Junk food is found just about everywhere. It's sold at supermarkets, workplaces, schools, and in vending machines. The availability and convenience of junk food make it difficult to limit or avoid. These highly processed snacks contain an abundance of calories, especially in the form of fat and sugar, and little to no vitamins, minerals, or fiber. Junk food is thought to be addictive. These addictive qualities are centered around the sugar and fat that they contain. Number 2. Hydrogenated vegetable oil. Hydrogenated vegetable oils do not go bad on the shelf, and the fact that they do not naturally break down means that your body is going to have a hard time breaking them down. Don't be fooled. These foods are not heart healthy. Avoid them at all costs. Hydrogenated oils can affect heart health because they increase bad cholesterol and lower good high-density lipoprotein or HDL cholesterol. On the other hand, a fully hydrogenated oil contains very little trans fat, mostly saturated fat, and doesn't carry the same health risks as trans fat. Eating oils like coconut, cacao butter, extra virgin olive oil from Greece or Italy to make sure it does not have other oils added to it, and even grass-fed organic butter are better for your body because they're recognizable as food. Number 1. Chicken. Chicken is probably the most popular pick among not-veggie lovers. Americans eat more chicken than any other meat. Chicken can be a nutritious choice, but raw chicken is often contaminated with Campylobacter bacteria, and sometimes with Salmonella and Clostridium perfringens bacteria. If you eat undercooked chicken, you can get a foodborne illness, also known as food poisoning. If you're a regular consumer of deep-fried chicken, then there is no doubt that your cholesterol level will spike. Chicken is considered to be a high-heat food. It can increase your body's overall temperature. In simpler terms, it can also cause heat in the body. Due to this, some people might experience a runny nose, especially during summers. If you experience a bloody nose after regularly eating chicken, it's best to eat it after a gap of a few days. So, viewers, that was it from today's video. If you want reviews of more tech products and top 10s, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to our channel. Till then, goodbye.